بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. رب جميلنا اللهم صل على محمد. আমরা আজকে এই লেকচারে কমপ্লিমেন্ট সিস্টেম সম্পর্কে আলোচনা করব ইনশাআল্লাহ। কমপ্লিমেন্ট সিস্টেম আমাদের যে সমস্ত প্রোটিন গুলো ইমিউন সিস্টেমে আছে, আমরা জানি অ্যান্টিবডিজ হলো নাম্বার ওয়ান, তারপরে কমপ্লিমেন্টস এবং তারপরে সাইটোকাইনস, সবাই মিলে তারা অনেক কাজ করে। তো আজকের কমপ্লিমেন্ট সিস্টেমের লেসন প্ল্যান হলো, আমরা ডেফিনিশন, হিস্ট্রি, ডিফারেন্ট পাথওয়েস, ক্লাসিক্যাল, অল্টারনেট, লেকটিন এবং হোয়াট আর দ্য বেনিফিশিয়াল অ্যান্ড এফেক্টস অফ কমপ্লিমেন্ট অ্যাক্টিভেশন, রিভিউ কোয়েশ্চেন যে সমস্তগুলো আমাদের এই লেকচারের পরে জানতে হবে, হোয়াট আর দ্য কমপ্লিমেন্টস, হোয়ার দে রিমেইন, হাউ কমপ্লিমেন্টস আর অ্যাক্টিভেটেড, হোয়াট আর দ্য পাথওয়েজ ফর কমপ্লিমেন্ট অ্যাক্টিভেশন, হোয়াট ইজ দ্য ফাইনাল এফেক্ট অফ কমপ্লিমেন্ট অ্যাক্টিভেশন, হোয়াট আর দ্য আদার বায়োলজিক্যাল এফেক্টস, সাম কমপ্লিমেন্ট মিডিয়েটেড ডিজিজ, হোয়াট আর কেমোটেক্সিন, anaphylatoxin, why complements needs to be activated, why antibodies present in the blood do not activate complement, which classes of antibodies can activate complement, which one is most efficient and why. তো আমরা শুরু করতে যাচ্ছি introduction. Complement system refers to a series of proteins circulating in the blood and bathing the fluids surrounding the tissues. This protein, they circulate in an inactive form. The antibody is always active, it is in an inactive form. But when activated, they act in concert and in an orderly sequence to exert their biological effects. Dutto term amra use korechi, in concert and in an orderly sequence. And a complement term, it refers to the ability of these proteins to complement, that is, augment the effects of other components of the immune system, that is, antibody. Shajanno enamta complement. Discovery of complement, history of the kidney, in 1884, Plifer demonstrated that some cholera vibrios can be lysed by guinea pig anti-cholera serum. অর্থাৎ cholera vibrio হলো antigen আর anti-cholera serum anti-antibody. But heating of the serum at 56 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes abolished this activity. But heating did not abolish the antibody activity because heated serum could still ট্রান্সফার ইমিউনিটি টু অ্যানাদার গিনি পিগ। তাহলে কি জানালো যে হিট করার ফলে কিছু একটা ধ্বংস হয়েছে যেটা অ্যান্টিবডি না। অ্যান এডিশন অফ নর্মাল ফ্রেশ সিরাম টু দ্যাট হিটেড অ্যান্টি সিরাম রেস্টোরস ইজ লাইটিক অ্যাক্টিভিটি। সো হি কনক্লুডেড দ্যাট অ্যান্টিবডিজ টু দ্য বেসিলাই ভিব্রিও কলেরি প্লাস এ হিট লেভাইল কম্পোনেন্ট প্রেজেন্ট ইন দ্য ইমিউ অ্যাজ ওয়েল অ্যাজ নর্মাল সিরাম ওয়ার নেসেসারি for the lysis of Vibrio cholerae in vitro. In 1890, Bordet and Early confirmed that the same result could be obtained in vitro, suspending Vibrios in the presence of fresh immune cell. এবং this এই আবিষ্কারের জন্য Nobel Prize পেয়েছিলেন Vincent Bordet in 1919. What is the outcome of complement activation? There are three main effects. First of all, lysis of the cells which activate the complement, such as bacteria, allograft, and tumor cell. Generation of mediators that participate in inflammation and attract neutrophils. And opsonization, that is enhancement of phagocytosis. So complement activation had three main effects: lysis of cells, generation of inflammatory mediators, and opsonization. So what are the beneficial effects of complement activation? There are six beneficial effects. Number one, it triggers inflammation. Number two, chemotactically attract phagocytes to the infection site. Number three, opsonization. Number four, lysis of gram-negative bacteria and human cell displaying foreign epitope. It also plays important role in activation of naive B lymphocytes and remove harmful immune complexes from the body. So there are six beneficial effects. What are the components of the complement system? There are more than 20 components, of which following are important, and some components are named as C1 to 9. So there are 9, C1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Some are named as factor, like factor B, factor D, factor H, factor I. And some are named differently, like properdin, C1 inhibitor, C4 binding protein, S protein, regulatory protein. How the complements are activated and why it needs to be activated. Several components of the components are proenzymes, which must be cleaved to form active enzymes. So they need to be activated. Activation of the complement can be initiated either by antigen-antibody complex or by variety of non-immunological molecules like endotoxin or cell wall of some bacteria. There are three pathways for complement activation: classical, lectin, and alternative, of which classical pathway belongs to acquired immunity, lectin and alternative pathway belongs to innate immunity. But ultimate result of the complement activation is recruitment of inflammatory cells, opsonization of pathogen, and lysis and death of the pathogen. This is the overview of the complement activation pathway. It starts with, say, antigen-antibody complexes, and we will discuss with some diagrams. Just you see, first in the classical pathway, it starts from binding of antibody IgM or IgG on a target surface. It binds on the target surface by its complement binding site, by its antigen binding site, and so it, Fc portion remains free. And in the Fc portion, there are complement binding site. So when the in the Fc portion, complement 1, that is 1Q, 1R, and 1S, they binds in the Fc portion, that leads to cleavage of second component, not 2, it is complement 4. Complement 4 divides into two fragments, 4B and 4A. B binds with the target along with the complement 1. This C activated C14B then acts on C2. C2 again, it divides into C2A and C2B. In some books it is written C2B comes in the membrane and C2A go to the circulation, but in some books different types is written. This C4B2A function as a C3 converters, and they convert the C3 into again C3A, C3B. C3B binds in the target membrane and C3A go to the circulation. This C4B, 2A, 3B acts as C5 converters. That is, it converts C5, cleaves C5 into C5A and C5B. C5A go to circulation, C5B in the target membrane. This C5 converter, that is C4B, 2A, 3B, C3, this C5 acts on then this C4B, 2A, 3B and C5B, they act on C, it attracts the C6, C7, C8 and many components of C9, which forms a membrane attack complex, and like drilling of the membrane, it drills the cell membrane and cell bursts. Alternate pathway begins with C3. This C3 binds to the cell wall and other surface components of the microbes. C3 can also bind to IgG antibodies. Factor B then combines with the cell bound C3B to form C3BB. Factor D then splits the bound factor B into BBB, forming C3BBB, which and propardine stabilizes this complex. It then acts on C5, and C5 is divided into C5A, C5B. Rest of the part is same. So you see, usually in the normal condition, C3 is cleaved into C3B, C3A. C3B binds with the cell membrane where factor B comes. Factor B is splitted by factor D into B, E and BA. BA goes to circulation. Propardine stabilizes this C3B, BBP. And they then act as C3 converters with more cleavage of C3. So C3A goes to circulation and C3B comes to the membrane. Finally, it acts. You see, this is the animation how C3BB is formed. Then factor D comes and it decleaves the B and propardine stabilizes this. Then they act on C3. This C3 is cleaved into C3A and C3B. So they act on C5. This is C5 converter during the alternate pathway, and C5 clips into C5A and C5B. This C5A and C5B, then factor 6, factor 7, C5B, 6, 7, 8, 9 comes, forms the membrane attack complex similar to classical pathway. You see, this is the animation of classical pathway. First, C1 QRS binds with the Fc portion. They act on C4. C4 go to the circulation. They act on C2, C2A and C2B. That acts on C3. And C3 will be converted into C3A, C3B. C3A and C3B. Finally, C5 will be cleaved into C5A, C5B, C5B binds with the membrane. It attracts C6, 7, 8, and 9. And this is known as MAC, that is membrane adduct complex. And finally, envelope viruses and gram-negative bacteria just lysis outburst. Lectin pathway is mediated by a menin-binding lectin, also known as menin-binding protein or MBP. It's a protein that binds to the mannose group found in many microbial carbohydrates. And when the menin-binding protein binds to the mannose group of microbial carbohydrate, this forms an enzyme similar to C1Q of classical complement pathway that is able to cleave C4 and C2 to form C4B and C2A. Just you can see the figure. The like C1QRS, menin-associated protein, menin-binding protein and MSP2, they act on C4, which finally acts on C2, and rest of the, just you can see the animation. Mannose group, mannose binding protein is coming with the binds to the anti-cell membrane, then menin-associated protein 1, menin-associated protein 2, then they act on C4, cleaves the C4, C4A and C4B, then acts on C2, finally C3. It acts on C3, C3 will C3A and C3B. So the rest of the pathway is similar. So small complement fragments, that is C3A, C4A, and C5A, which go into circulation, they act as chemotaxins to attract inflammatory cells, such as the neutrophils, to the site of complement activation, that is site of infection. And they also act as anaphylatoxins and induce degranulation of mast cells that release histamine and other vasoactive substances that increase vascular permeability. Regarding triggering inflammation, C5A is the most potent complement protein that triggers inflammation. They release histamine from mast cell, thereby vasodilation and increased permeability. Increased expression of adhesive molecules on leukocytes and vascular epithelium. So leukocytes can squeeze out of the blood vessel and enter the tissue, known as diapedesis. It causes neutrophils to release toxic oxygen radicals for extracellular killing, and it induces fever. To a lesser extent, C3A and C4A also promote inflammation. Chemotaxis C5A functions as chemotactic molecule and opsonization, promoting, you know, enhancement. Enhanced phagocytosis is also known as opsonization. C3B and C4B can function as opsonates. One portion of C3B binds to microbial surface, another portion to CR1 receptors on phagocyte, B lymphocyte, and dendritic cell for enhanced phagocytosis. You can see animation. This is the animation, how complement C3B, you see, this is enhancement of phagocytosis by immunoglobulin G. And a similar thing can occur by complement fragment C3B. Cytolysis C5B 6, 7, 8, 9 function as membrane attack complex. This helps to destroy gram-negative bacteria as well as human cell displaying foreign antigen like virus infected cell, tumor cell, etc., by causing their lysis. It can also damage the envelope virus. They also play a role for activation of naive B lymphocyte. Some C3B is converted to C3D. C3D binds to CR2 receptor on B lymphocytes, and this serves as a second signal for activation of B lymphocytes, whose B cell receptor have just interacted with their corresponding antigen. Immune complex, always harmful immune complexes are formed in the body, and C3B and to a lesser extent C4B help to remove harmful immune complexes from the body. C3B and C4B attaches the immune complexes to CR1 receptor on erythrocytes. These erythrocytes then deliver the complexes to fixed macrophage within the spleen and liver cell for destruction. Where the complements are produced and how they are regulated? They are synthesized from liver, spleen, macrophages, and intestinal epithelial cells. They are regulated by various inactivators like C1 esterase inhibitor, C3b inhibitor, anaphylatoxin inhibitor, and metabolic degradation. Complement mediated disease, there are two groups of disease. One is hypersensitivity mediated and another one is deficiency disease. Hypersensitivity, type 2 and type 3 hypersensitivity, they are hypersensitivity mediated. And deficiency disease are deficiency of C5 to C8 enhances susceptibility to Neisseria infection. Deficiency of C3 results in severe recurrent pyogenic and respiratory tract infection. Inherited deficiency of C1 esterase inhibitor leads to angioedema. And acquired deficiency of decay accelerating factor leads to paroxysmal nocturnal hemoglobinuria. Mismatched ABO transmission is also complement mediated, and immune complex mediated disease, type 3 hypersensitivity. These are the complement mediated diseases. Let us do a summary. Complement consists of serum proteins in inactive form, which when activated, they act in concert in an orderly sequence to exert their biological effects. Biological effects of complement activation include cytolysis of the target, opsonization, immune adherence, a release of mediators of inflammation, and chemotaxis. There are three pathways for activation: classical, alternate, and lectin mediated. Deficiency of complement is associated with many diseases like SLE, increased susceptibility to infection, nephritis, etc. So, review questions. What are the complements and where they remain? They remain in the blood and body fluids. How they are activated? They are activated by three pathways. What is the final effect of complement activation? That is membrane attack complex. What are the other biological effects? Inflammation, chemotaxis, cytochemotaxis and opsonization, removal of harmful immune complexes. What are anaphylatoxin and chemotaxin? Why complements need to be activated? Because they remain as proenzyme, and by cleaving, by activation, they become enzyme. Why antibodies present in the blood do not activate complement? Because the complement binding site of the antibody remains folded, and when it binds to the antigen, that is exposed and binds with the complement. Which class of antibodies can activate the complement? Immunoglobulin G and immunoglobulin M. Which one is most effective? Most efficient? Immunoglobulin M is most efficient because it has got 5 Fc fragment. A single immunoglobulin M can activate the complement, but by activation by immunoglobulin G, at least 2 immunoglobulin G side by side requires to activate the complement. So wish you all the best. Thank you very much.